Welcome to Wisconsin Metal Parts continuing education about stamping dies. If you appreciate this information, please like us, share us, or subscribe to our YouTube channel. Today we're going to be talking over some basics about draw dies, where we have a part that starts out as a flat piece of steel and eventually becomes a round drawn cup. Draw dies, we can do many different things with draw dies and many different types of parts. This is an example that I'm going to be discussing today that has a little bit of coining on it. It has a flange, and finally we have the part that gets cut off at the end of the die. So when you're drawing steel out of a flat piece, there are certain limitations that you're going to run into with the different types of materials. You can only pull and stretch material so far before it's going to crack or fail and break. So when you're doing a drawn part, you sometimes have to have some pre-draws before you get to your final part. We use our design software to calculate what those percentages are. And in SolidWorks with our LogoPress add-on, there's calculation software where it tells us what the calculations will be and what percentages need to happen. So as you can see with this part here, we're starting out with having to move some of the material. In this stage here, we're getting a little bit smaller in diameter, but we're getting a little bit deeper. And in this stage here, we're getting a little smaller and a little longer as well. And then finally here, we're crisping up some of the radiuses at the bottom, and we're tightening up this radius at the bottom shoulder. That's all specific to this part and what the customer needs on their part print. When we look at the beginning of this part, we've got this strange cut here, which we call a blank double blank. If you have seen our other video on progressive dies, I talked extensively about pilot holes and how important it is to maintain a pilot all the way through so we can qualify exactly where that part is within the die. If we were to come down here and just start moving all this material, this strip stock would suck in and all of our pilot holes would move, and we'd have no way of telling where that tool is throughout this, or where the part strip is throughout the tool. So what we do in this case is called a blank double blank, where part of the material is staying attached to the strip and some of it is getting cut free. And you can see the results of what happens here. Now it's going to allow these stretch webs to keep the part, keep attached to the part, so we know where the part is in the strip, but also still be attached to the strip and not mess with our pilot holes throughout the die. And these stretch webs, as we move, get more and more important. So in this case, we've got a 12 station die to make our final part. Four of those stations are in the draw, and then we've got some coining that happens here, and then we've got a hole that gets pierced, and then another piercing station here that enlarges the hole. We've got a couple of stations here that are idle where nothing is happening, and finally the finished part gets blanked out and cut off at the end. Now in this case we've got a couple of idle stations because this particular tool makes three different parts, and we've got some different interchangeable inserts that we can put in here that some of these other stations would get used with. At Wisconsin Metal Parts, we design, build, and run metal stampings, including draw dies. If you've got a specific project you'd like our help on, please go to our website at wisconsinmetalparts.com. We serve with purpose, pride, and passion, and our team welcomes challenges.